Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. You humans love to put yourself into categories. Dog person or cat person, type A or type B, Scorpio or Taurus. I'll admit, I even do this sometimes. I'm a Ravenclaw Virgo ENFJ, and I love dogs and cats, in case you were wondering. People even use these categories to make important life decisions. We think of these things like the Myers-Briggs type indicator and other personality tests as giving us some sort of explanation as to why we are the way we are. Because of that, we place a ton of weight on them when it comes to decisions like what career path to go down, or which college to attend. We treat them like they're based on scientific facts, but are they really that meaningful? Well, for starters, let's define these terms. The Myers-Briggs Type Indicator, also known as the MBTI, is a test that supposedly reveals four facets of your personality: introversion versus extroversion, sensing versus intuition, thinking versus feeling, and judging versus perceiving. It involves a series of questions about your tendencies and preferences, all of which results in a set of four letters that are supposed to sum you up as a person. Apparently, people who are introverted, sensing, thinking, and judging are best suited for jobs like school administrators, airline pilots, or dentists, while ESFPs should work as teachers, flight attendants, or dental hygienists. Yeah, seriously. Another common personality descriptor that people love to read into is their zodiac sign. Your zodiac sign, which is a sign given to you based on how the sun was aligned when you were born, is thought by many to determine a lot of your characteristics. For instance, a Scorpio, which is someone who was born between October 23rd and November 22nd, is supposed to be jealous and stubborn, while a Capricorn, someone who was born between December 22nd and January 19th, is responsible and condescending. One common thread among these personality tests and horoscopes is something called the Barnum Effect, which basically says that people believe that personality descriptions given as a result of a personality test are highly accurate and suit them specifically, even when the same list of traits is actually given to everyone who took the personality test. This is because the given traits are what's known as high base rate characteristics, meaning that they're true to a large portion of the population. Examples of high base rate characteristics are statements like, "Sometimes you're too hard on yourself," or "You really want other people to like you." Does that sound just like you? Well, it sounds like a lot of people, and that's the point. So now you might be thinking, these tests don't sound very scientific. Well, you're right. While the creators of the MBTI test claim it was based on the work of psychologist C.G. Jung, many modern psychologists agree that it's not really based in any legitimate psychology. In fact, a group of characteristics known as the Big Five, which are extroversion, neuroticism, agreeableness, conscientiousness, and openness, are regarded as alternative personality descriptors that are actually based on the scientific method. It's believed that the Big Five may actually have some bearing on things like job performance, and some scientists have even worked to locate regions of the brain that can be associated with individual aspects of the Big Five. In their 2010 study, they found that conscientiousness, for example, is significantly correlated with the volume of the middle frontal gyrus, a section of the brain's prefrontal cortex. So while the Big Five appear to be legitimate, the Myers-Briggs type indicator and other tests that heavily depend on the Barnum effect seem, well, fake. So don't worry if you don't know your personality type or if it changes every time you take the test. It won't do you that much good anyway. And you're fine the way you are. So, do you have a personality type? Do you believe in horoscopes? Let me know in the comment section below. Or tell us, what should we talk about next? Want to watch another Life Noggin video? How about this episode on what if you never saw the sun? If you were never exposed to any sunlight, you would almost definitely be lacking in this important nutrient unless you were taking vitamin D supplements. It's almost impossible to get the amount of vitamin D you need from food alone. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.